Hello friends, the topic for today is Embedded Systems for Beginners. Let us start our discussion with computer system or computing system. A computing system consists of processor, that is nothing but the central processing unit CPU, computer memory, which are of two types, ROM and RAM, and input-output peripheral devices. These systems are found everywhere. Today, there are more computers in our homes and offices than there are people who live and work in them. Yet, many of these computing systems are not recognized as such by their users. In this video, I will explain what embedded systems are and the application domain of embedded systems and characteristics of embedded systems. Let us start with what is embedded system. An embedded system is a computer system, a combination of computer hardware and software, and perhaps additional mechanical or other parts designed to perform a specific or dedicated function. So it is embedded, meaning hidden inside, as a part of a complete device. As embedded systems typically controls physical operations of a machine in which it is embedded, it often has real-time computing constraints. Embedded systems control many devices in common use today. Then let us compare embedded systems with PC or personal computer. Embedded system has dedicated function. This is in direct contrast to personal computer or PC, which is not designed to perform a specific function. Rather than, it is able to do many different things. Many people use the term general purpose computer to make this distinction. A general purpose computer is a blank slate. The manufacturer does not know what customer will do with it. One customer may use it for network file server, another may use it exclusively for playing games, and the third may use it to write a novel. Hence, personal computer is not an embedded system. But it is important to point out that a general purpose computer itself is made up of numerous embedded systems. For example, my computer consists of keyboard, mouse, video card, modem, hard drive, and sound card, each of which is an embedded system. Each of these devices contain a processor and a software and is designed to perform a specific function. For example, modem is designed to send and receive digital data over analog telephone line. That's it. That's why it is an embedded system. Then let us now see the application domains of embedded system. Electronic devices in just about every engineering market segment are classified as embedded system. The application domains of embedded systems percolates every element of modern life. So it will be easy to understand its features once we take a tour of the world of embedded system. So let us start the tour with consumer electronics. So here we have cameras, music players, televisions, analog and digital televisions, then DVD players, microwave ovens, washing machines, refrigerators, and remote control. All are embedded systems. Then next we have household appliances or home security systems, air conditioners, intruders and fire alarm systems. These are the embedded system in this. Then next we have automobile control. So anti-lock braking systems, ignition systems and engine control, doors and wiper control, etc. These are some of the embedded systems in automobile sector. Then handheld devices. Mobile phones, MP3 players, DG cams, These are the embedded system in handheld device. Then next we have medical equipment. Scanners, ECG and EEG units, dialysis machines, infusion pumps, cardiac monitors, etc. These are the embedded systems used in medical equipment. Then next we are banking sector. ATMs, currency counters are the embedded system in banking. Then office automation, fax machines, photocopiers, printers, monitors and scanners. These are the embedded systems used in office automation. Then next we have networking. Routers, switches, hubs and gateways. These are the embedded systems in network. Then next we have aviation sector. Airplane controls, guidance and instrumentation system. These are the embedded system. Then next is industrial control. Robotics and control systems used for manufacturing. These are the embedded systems in industrial control. Then lastly, we have the toys and games. Here also we have embedded systems. They are used in the toys and games. Then let us go to the characteristics of embedded system. The most embedded systems are designed for dedicated or specific function. For example, a pager is always functions as page. However, we now see devices such as personal digital assistant, PDA or cell phone hybrids, which are embedded system designed to do a variety of functions. As you might have experienced, with the help of cell phone, you can do a lot of functions. Then second characteristic, it should be designed for low power dissipation because many systems are battery operated. That's why if the power dissipation is low, the life of battery will be more. Then next, it must perform fast enough to process data in real time. The one subsection of embedded system is real-time system. So the speed has to be enough to process data in real time. Then we have the need to be highly reliable system. Then last, the size should be small as possible and the cost should be low. So these are some of the general characteristics of embedded system. Then we take a generic embedded system. All embedded system contain a processor and software. But what are other features do they have in common? Let us see that. In order to have software, there must be a place to store executable code and temporary storage for runtime data manipulation. So these take the form of read-only memory and random access memory or RAM. Any embedded system will have some of each. So if only a small amount of memory is required, it might be contained within a same chip as the processor. Otherwise, one or both types of memory will reside in externally memory chip. All embedded system also contain some type of input and output. The inputs to the system usually take the form of sensors and probes, communication signals, and control knobs and buttons. The outputs are typically displays, communication signals or changes to the physical world. General example of embedded system. Here in the figure, you see the general example of embedded system. So with this, we come to the end of this video. This was just a brief introduction to embedded system. Thank you.